Hi everyone, it's Jean. I'm stopping by because I was on one of the Facebook groups that I participate in on occasion. It's called Magpie Treasures. And there was a young lady on there, and please forgive me, I can't remember her name. But she had tried to make a snippet strip, she calls it. And these are so fun. And you need very little supplies. I actually printed some black and white images. And then some of these other things are Tim Holtz, I think from his field note packs. But I just love the idea of it. I don't know if I could bring myself to cut it into pieces to put into a journal, but I want to show you my method of making one of these and for you to see how you feel about using them in your journals, whether you would maybe fold them in half and use one on one page and one on another page, or if you wanted to cut it right here where this floral and this butterfly is, you could do that. But I think they're really fun. And I've been enamored with this orange and rose kind of like upholstery fabric of sorts that I found. So on this one, I thought maybe I would build based on the strip, but I'm not sure that I'm going to do that because then I'll have all orange on it. So what I did is I have a pack of, it's cardstock by Color Bock. I'm pretty sure you can get this at Walmart. It has 30 sheets in it, but it's 12 by 12, so you get a lot of pages. It's not very thick, though. It doesn't say, I don't think it says the weight on it. No, I'm not seeing the weight, but I just cut some strips of it, and I use my ruler, so they're not anything special, but I thought what I would do is just give you an idea of how I made this first one. So what I have is just a pile of like black and white images. I have some butterflies. I have some Tim Holtz labels. Over here, I have some book pages that I had torn up. And I also have some sheet music. And the book pages and sheet music, they're pieces that I've either tea stained, or they might have stamping on like this one. So I think the best way to start the snippet strip in my situation is to cover it with some kind of book paper. And when you're covering it with the book paper and you're using the music sheet paper too, kind of alternate it and layer it so we're not all, here I have a stack of just pieces. Kim would be happy that I'm using up my scraps. So I'm just kind of going to kind of tear these and put them on. And I like the longer pieces. And just tear them out. And sometimes I like to keep the page numbers on. So I'll tear a piece of that. This is tea stain, so I'm not going to be... let me lay this finished one over here. I'm not going to be inking these or anything. I didn't ink on the other one. I may go around the edge later, but for the most part, I'm just going to take sheet music and book paper to put down on the background. I'm not going to cover the brown completely because you won't need to once you start adding some of the images. But what I've found is, you know, your images are going to be different shapes, so, or your labels. So I have some round labels, and you need something in between your images if you're going to use something like a round label. I'm going to pull a piece of this off, and I'm going to just lay this right here so it overlaps. This was a page that I was practicing some stamping on, which I really like the effect of the black stamping on top of whatever you're using, like book paper or what have you. I'm going to actually try to stick that underneath. So this is what I kind of do, is I go in sections and see how much paper I need to lay down or how much more I may need. So these are just images that I printed. And created. Sorry for the big sigh there. I got my coffee late in the afternoon today. So, this young lady looks kind of odd, but she's holding what looks to be, I can't tell if it's a bouquet of feathers or a bird nest or what she's carrying. So I'm just going to trim off this white here so that it has just a brown frame. And I don't want to put her on the complete edge, and I want to get most of her body in here. So I'm going to cut the top, and that way I'll have most of her image in here. And I'm not going to worry about these things that are not... what do I want to say? Cut even, because when I get this glue is the best glue, but it is sometimes such a pain in the neck. I'll end up probably putting things on the top where that little bit of a ragged edge is, and I won't worry so much about it right now. And I want to use some of this orange fabric in it. So I tore a piece of this that is like one of the hemmings, and I like that, but I was going to try to find some over here, some that has some more of a floral look to it. So let me tear this off. And I love this shabby stringy edge coming off here. So I didn't glue that all the way down because I want to add that to the edge. And that way it'll give it shabby kind of edge on the side. And give me just a moment here. I might try to tear this edge if I can. It actually tears pretty well because it's, I think it's older, but I like that ripped look. So we'll see if we can get that with this. Kind of hard to see on my fabric I have here. Let me find a piece of, here's a piece of tea stain paper. I'll just lay it on here and that'll give it a little better view. And I'm not so worried about everything having straight edges because as you go along and you add things in between, it kind of takes that away anyway. So we have some other women here. I can't even see what that is. Here's a floral. This would be nice. And we can put it up higher. Okay. I'm gonna just put my glue onto the snippet base so I don't get glue on the part that I don't need. And I like leaving my edges uneven like I did here. Now, as you can see, they're not that exaggerated. If I turn it on the back, there's not much that's higher than the base except for a couple pieces here. But I like that fact that some comes off of the edge and it's not all going to be even with your base. So I'm going to cut this one too. And I need a little bit more. Let's use a little bit more of this because this looks nice on the bottom here. And we'll put it, it's upside down. I think the other piece was too, but that's okay. And I wanted to kind of overlap some of the places, like overlapping onto this. And to me, this is just like kind of like collaging where you put different pieces in different places. But with this, we're trying to make a cohesion between everything that's going down the line. So here I have an interesting clock. And I think I'm going to add him, but I want something in the middle of this. So let me see what... This is really cool. These are perfect for in between there. Mushrooms are always fun to work with. And if you all haven't visited the coffee shops that I have listed, and you like using digitals, you're really missing out, because some of the girls that I work with have some amazing digitals, and they offer a lot of their digitals. Some, you know, they always offer a good selection in the free portion, and then under the membership portion as well. So if you get a chance to hop over there and look, I would encourage you, because there's so many options for printables that are free to anybody who accesses the site. So that's cool with that little clock there. And I like the idea of adding some of these. These are like little specimens, I think. I like adding those. I don't want to add all women, though. So let me see about this gent. Let's put a strip of book paper here, and I hope you all can see this well. I'm usually tape or recording in the evening, so sometimes my lighting is not that well, not that good. So I'm going to lay this right over the edge of the clock, so it kind of blends everything in. Now, I think we need to put a piece of the fabric at this point, just to tie in that color. So let me snip a piece of this. And we use this one. I think I want to use a piece going. I'm going to cut this off because I really, really like the end of this and how it looks. So I want it to be really roughed up. And I'm just going to add it right in here, and then we'll see what we can add on top of it or underneath it or however we're going to do it. So I'm going to put this right here. I just felt like this was the place where I needed to add some more of the color. So let me put... I think I'll use the butterfly one. So what have you all been watching on TV or Netflix or whatever service you have? I was watching Grey's Anatomy, but that became just the same thing almost. It's like it's the same thing pretty much every episode or, you know, situation. It just keeps repeating itself. So I was getting tired of that. And then I was watching Vikings, and I couldn't watch that because it was just about killing people. So now I am going to restart the blacklist because the blacklist actually has newer shows that are coming up. So it's got a pretty large list of seasons that I can watch because I'm a binge watcher of a lot of those things. This couple is kind of comical, so I'm going to stick them in here. And I like using the fabric when I'm making either adding a lady or adding a couple, because I kind of think of it as their fabric for their wedding or something exciting that they've done. So a little bit of nostalgia in there, if you want to call it that. Okay, so more book paper here. And I don't have any more that I have stamped on. So I'm just going to go with the plain. Pieces. Okay, so for this one, I'm gonna lay down like that. And this one, I will lay like this. I really think this lady with her wild hair should go on here. I'm just going to leave it tacked down a little bit like that. And then we will put something right here to kind of cover up that blank space. Now, the young lady that posted hers on Magpie Treasures, I'll have to leave her channel below, but her snippet was so beautiful with the different images that she chose to use and how she did hers. So when you get a chance, you can check that out and see how you like it. And then what I think we end up doing is coming back and adding labels and things different places, whoops, so that it makes the snippet more interesting. Okay, so this lady, she needs to be cut off somewhere there. And I'm just going to bend this one over and bend this one over because I don't want them too much higher than what the snippet base is. Okay, so let me add another piece of this. And I'm going to rough it up a little bit. And then use this along the side there. And then, let's see. I have some other images here, so I like this gentleman. I'm going to put him on. And the weather has been nice and warm here, like in the 50s. So at nighttime, I've been used to it being in the 30s. So I'm not really a super fan of the warm weather. And I'll be regretting it in a month or so, because I just don't, me and the warm weather just don't get along. So here we have three pieces of the fabric, and I think I'm going, let me just put something on the end here. Let me see if I have, I don't know if I have any more clocks or not. Let me see. Here's one. Here's one. Some of them I had cars too, so. I think I'll use this clock. It has an Eiffel Tower in the background. So I'm just going to add this to the end, and then we'll see if there's anything we need to snip off or add later. Let me go up with this. Okay, so now we have most of the images on, and we have the fabric that we want on as far as the orange floral fabric. Now we can bring in some other things that will accentuate the piece and stick with that kind of orangey theme. And I thought I had some flowers here then that would go like over here. To cover some of that brown. And there's this huge bee. I don't like bees. I'm going to save all the bee images and send them to Caroline or somebody, because I don't like them. Could put a butterfly there. That's too close to the other one. Maybe that's what we need here on the end. Like a butterfly right here. And that helps to cover up some of that squiggly edge that we cut. That I cut. So we can put that right there. And we need something for the end here. Let's see. How does your garden grow? Cockle bells and something else. I can't believe I can't remember that. How does your garden grow? With cockle shells and something else, and something all in a row. So if anybody remembers, please refresh my memory. So these field notes kind of have the right color for what we're doing here in making, adding in that orange fabric really helps to bring in, tie it all in together, because the field notes have some orange on them. Or colors that will match, like here's a little bit of red. Pardon me, somebody else was saying when they did a video, they yawned. Well, that's me. When I do a video, I yawn. Oops, I don't want to cover up her head too much. See, this is where I start to then, this gets a little bit more, how do I want to say it? Outside of the strip and being a little bit more uneven as I add different things to it to kind of come up with ways to layer these. And then once you put down your base ones, you may find that some of the other ones look nice hanging over the edge a little bit. So that's where I'm going to put that one. And I put these flowers here. And I need something to cover this up. And I'm not sure if I have anything that I can use. Here's a little circle. We could use that and put that right there. Okay, that's a good idea. I like the Tim Holtz. Some of his die cut packages have all different shapes and sizes, and I love that. I can make a lot of my own images, but I don't always have the time to fussy cut and add all these other extra things that come along with cutting out die cuts, because it takes a long time to fussy cut images and pieces of ephemera. So, not that I'm complaining, I love to do it, but it, when you have the field notes or some of his other interesting things, you can get your projects done a lot faster because he has things that we can use that make it more, you know, make your projects go quicker. And I, you know, I'm a fan of Tim Holtz. I don't think that with today's creative abilities that we have from so many artists that are on YouTube and other places, I don't think we have to rely on someone like Tim Holtz to design, you know, to be a designer for our project, because he is not the only creator out there that makes things that are fabulous for junk journaling or collaging in general. So don't limit yourself just to his things, because there's definitely more. You just have to look for it. Okay, so I love this so far. It needs something right here and probably something down here. So let me see what happened to, let's see if we can put these little tiny mushrooms right there, or mushroom, and that'll even that out a little bit. And I'll tell you one thing about using this beacon glue. Sometimes it's stringy and sometimes it's messy and it bubbles up outside of the container, and you think like you think as if you're wasting a lot. But honestly, the reason I love this glue is because nothing warps. As you can see, nothing has warped on this at all. And that's good, because we don't want a warped page. I'm gonna go down here and put just this little. Okay, so right here, I need a label or something to go right in the middle, like a skinny, something skinny. I could put this dragonfly. No, he's not too. I could put him there. We'll put the dragonfly on the clock. And that'll break up that seam right there, but it still will allow us to see the young boy, who looks like one of my friends, my son's friends. So I really like that. So if you look at this, and this is just to give you an idea of how I look at things. So when I look at this, I see that it's even on this side with the exception of these two pieces. But here, it seems like it's a lot heavier than it is here. So what we have to do as a result is add some things back here or that fit under that will make it more even. Because if you look at this one, it kind of all goes and is even on its design. But this one, definitely you can tell it needs things on this edge. And that's my process of doing things, is looking at which side looks heavier than the other side and go from there. So I don't know what I'm going to add, because I have okay, here's a mushroom. Let me see something about this. This could go. Let me see if I can lift up the butterfly. Sometimes I only glue things like in the middle also, in the event that I need to lift them up to put something underneath. So I'm going to lift this butterfly up, and I'm going to put this just a raggedy leftover piece of that trim I took off, and I'm going to put it right in here. And then what will happen is that'll start to add, build up some of the height that we need for this. And let's see, we could also, I don't think I have any more of that trim right here. That's probably all of it. Let me see if I can locate some. I think that was off of a doily that had accidentally gotten stained. So I just ripped the rest of it up. Let's see what I have in here. Here's just a piece of regular, like the end of a piece of lace or something. Let me just put a little bit of glue right here. I hope I'm staying in frame for you guys. I tend to pull stuff toward myself to work on it, so. I don't know if you saw my little video I did on the nosegays, the Tussie Mussies, but I have those pretty much finished. I put them on, I put pinbacks on them, so if they wanted to wear them, they could. So I'm praying they don't fall apart between here and Chile. Okay, I'm just putting a little grouping of lace right there, and I'm going to see if I have a button, because you know I like to use buttons, and see that orange one's cool. This color go sort of. How about this color? Here's an orangey one. This looks like an old button. It's been in the sun or something. So I'm gonna put this button right here. And it already has thread in it, so we have that. And then there should be somewhere in so I need to put something like a label here. Sorry, sometimes when I'm working, even though I'm filming, I talk to myself. So, please forgive me. That's going to cover up his head. Okay. Okay, so that gave it a little bit more lift over here, this little label. And I thought I had a butterfly that was going this way, and I wanted to put it on top of this lace right here, and I think that gives it more of an even look. One other thing I may add, and let me see if I can find one. This one's a big one, a smaller label to go right here on the end. There, I think that's okay. This has to come over top. I think that looks good. So it's all about building layers so that you can then create something from all the bits and pieces that we have. So I was able to use up some of these black and white images that I had printed, and a lot of leftover Tim Holtz pieces and bits, which I really think was beneficial because you have all that and don't do anything with it and hoard it and it just becomes a bigger and bigger pile. So we were able to use some of his things and also some book pages and some trim that we tore apart. We also used some of the orange material and frayed that and used it on our project. And that's what I think helps it to be cohesive and interesting, because usually as junk journalists or mixed media artists, one of the things that you will notice is that we love to feel things, to see what things feel like when, especially when they're finished. And this one, this project, gives us a lot of things that we can feel on here. We can feel the material, the different layering techniques. So thank you to the young lady who shared hers. I'm sure mine's not the same. And that's the great thing about making projects and giving a twist to them from what you see someone else make, because we each have our own individuality. So I am having a little contest on my Facebook page. I will be typing it up today. And it's basically a participation contest. So over the last few videos that I've made, including this one, I've made some tags. I've made the little tussie mussies, if you want to attempt to that. And now I've made these are called, I think, snippet strips, she calls them. And so we've made these. So the contest is if you post a separate post on my Facebook page saying that you watched one of my videos and this is the project that you tried from that video, I want you to let me know on my Facebook page. And as a result of that, you will get an envelope of goodies from me. It may be some Tim Holtz goodies. It could be some images that I've made or I've printed off. So it'll be a nice envelope with things in it that you can use for your future projects. So please put your information. Usually when you post, we get your information, so that should be fine. But get your information together and post something, a tag, just a special project you're making, or one of these snippet strips, and I will send that out for you. So the website, or I'm sorry, the Facebook group is Lilac Lane Livery Arts, and you can find me, of course, on Facebook, and we would love to see what you come up with. So thank you so much for watching. I appreciate your attention to my video today. I'm hoping to gain a few more subscribers. So if you know anybody that would be interested in this type of art, please let them know. And I appreciate you stopping by. That's all for now.